Tiling window managers, I can't get enough of them. Every time I hear about a new tiling window manager, I've got to check it out, especially if it's written in a meme programming language. And Rust is certainly the latest meme, and today I want to check out a tiling window manager that's written in Rust called LeftWM. The website for LeftWM can be found at leftwm.org, and they talk about why they wrote a tiling window manager written in Rust. They wrote it in Rust for, quote, stability and performance. And you know, looking around at some of the screenshots, there's some really nice theming going on. And one of the really interesting things about LeftWM that really separates it from other tiling window managers is LeftWM, quote, is built for themes, meaning, you know, you create your own custom color scheme, your panel, you know, whatever panel you want to use. There's not a built-in panel with LeftWM. So if you want to use Polybar, great. If you want to use XMobar, great. And you can theme them however you want. You create your own theme that is placed in your .config folder at .config/leftwm/themes. And it's easy to share your theme with the world. And your theme is just your theme. Really, it's just the colors and the panel. It's not your key bindings. Your key bindings are a completely different file separate from the theming. And I think that's a really neat feature for LeftWM. And I do think it makes LeftWM stand out a little bit from the crowd. For those of you that want to install LeftWM, the source code for it is hosted over on GitHub, so you can grab the source code there. What I would suggest for those of you on Arch or an Arch-based distribution, LeftWM is in the AUR. I believe there's two AUR packages, LeftWM and LeftWM-Git. I just installed the LeftWM package. I installed it with the Paru AUR helper, and it built just fine. It really didn't take that long to install. And let me show you my LeftWM desktop. Now, LeftWM will not look like this out of the box. When you first log into LeftWM, it's very reminiscent for those of you that have ever installed a really minimal window manager like Xmonad, for example, because LeftWM is in a lot of ways like Xmonad. It's just not written in Haskell. It's written in Rust. But when you first log into LeftWM, chances are you're going to have a black screen. You're not going to have a wallpaper set of any kind. There's not going to be a panel, right? It's just a black desktop. But you do have some key bindings that do work. There's a default config on the system that allows you to bring up a terminal, bring up a run prompt. The default terminal that LeftWM expects to be on your system is Alacrity. Why is that the case? Well, Alacrity is a terminal. It's a really nice terminal, and it's written in Rust. So I strongly urge you guys, if you're not using the Alacrity terminal, check it out. It's a fantastic terminal. And the default key binding to bring up that terminal is super, which is the mod key, super shift enter, brings up a terminal. And that's very similar to the default key bindings in Xmonad. The default key bindings in Xmonad are mod key shift enter to bring up a terminal. In Xmonad, the default key binding to bring up a run prompt, a dmenu prompt, is the mod key plus P for prompt. And here, super P in LeftWM also brings up dmenu. This is dmenu at the top, and I could launch something. Maybe I wanted, I don't know, PCManFM, you know, for a graphical file manager. The default key binding to close a window is super shift Q to close. Super Shift X will exit out of LeftWM, so be careful. One of the things, because I switch between so many different tiling window managers, I often find myself fumbling around every time I switch. So what I end up typically doing is I make every tiling window manager that I use the same key binding so I don't accidentally kill the window manager when I meant to close a window, for example. So shortly after I finish recording this video, I'm probably going to change a lot of the key bindings to suit my needs. I left them as default, though, for purposes of this video. The only thing that's not default, though, really, is the fact that I have a wallpaper and that I have Polybar as a panel at the top. I also played a little bit with XMobar with LeftWM, and XMobar plays nice with LeftWM for those of you that want to just stick with XMobar if you already have it on the system because you use Xmonad. Now, I did not theme this Polybar. What I did is I wanted to check out the theming features in LeftWM. So if I go back to the GitHub for LeftWM, somewhere down here, they talk about the theming and they give you a link to the community repository for sharing themes. And you get to this repository, LeftWM Community Themes. And you have different themes that you can try out. Also, in the standard LeftWM config here, or a repository that is, if you go to their themes folder, You have basic poly bar, basic exmo bar, also basic lemon bar. And I downloaded both the basic poly bar theme and the basic exmo bar theme. And both of those seem to work just fine. Let me show you how you get these themes to work. So if I switch back to the desktop here, and let me do a super shift enter to get a terminal, and let me zoom in here, and I'll open the config file here with Vim. So let me do a Vim space and then dash config slash leftwm slash config dot toml, T-O-M-L. And this is the default config file. I haven't changed anything except for two things because they were annoying me a little bit. First of all, the tags by default, they're 1 through 9. I gave them names. I gave them the exact same 9 names that I use in every other window manager. So that's really the only thing I changed. I also changed the default keybinding to bring up a terminal. By default, it is set to Alacrity. But of course, the default shell on my system would open Alacrity using the bash shell. I wanted to use the fish shell, so I changed the value from Alacrity to Alacrity-E fish, because I want Alacrity to always immediately launch the fish shell when it launches, you know, and the fish shell gives me nice, you know, coloring and auto completion and everything that I really miss if I'm in bash or ZSH. So I just prefer fish. Everything else, though, I left as the default key bindings, although I'm going to end up changing a lot of them because I don't like using the arrow keys. You see a lot of key bindings that involve the up key, the down key, up, down, left, right. I would prefer those to actually be the Vim motion keys, HJKL, because that's what they are in every other tiling window manager. So it would be confusing to use the arrow keys instead of the HJKL keys, but they do work. If I want to change focus between these two windows with the keyboard, I believe super and the down key, yeah, and the super up key, down goes one direction, up goes another. If you want to send a window to a different workspace, you could do super shift and then whatever the number of the workspace, maybe workspace 4. So super shift 4 will take this terminal that has focus and move it to workspace 4. And if I move to workspace 4 with super 4, you know, that terminal is on the fourth workspace. If I go back to the second workspace, this terminal's still here. Let me go back to the fourth workspace, and I'm going to do super shift 2 to send it back to the second workspace. I'm going to do super 2 for me to move back to the second workspace, and everything is still here. Now let me close this empty terminal that I really didn't need, and I'm going to do super P again to bring up my D menu. And let's actually bring up a graphical file manager. Let me get into PCManFM. Now in your home directory, you have a .config folder. This is where all your user config files for most of your programs get placed. So go into .config and look for a folder called LeftWM. And then by default, you're going to have config.toml there. This is just your default config. You're not going to have a themes folder. Create a themes folder. And when you create a themes folder, go and download some themes and place them in here. And where do you go? Well, I just grabbed basic exmo bar and basic poly bar, and I put them in here. Of course, you also have the community repository of themes that were here. And there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 themes. You could grab any of those and also just drop them into that themes folder. So once you have that, then whichever one you want to actually use. Right now I'm using basic polybar. And what you need to do is create a symlink linking basic polybar to current. And it actually gives you the command on the GitHub page. Yeah, here at the bottom of the GitHub page, it gives you the command to add the symlink that you need. Let me zoom in. There's the make directory command to make the .config slash leftwm slash themes directory, which we had already made. You know, I already had that directory here. And then you need to run this command, ln for link dash s. It's going to be a symbolic link, and it needs to be whatever theme you want to be your default theme, such as basic polybar, which is the one I set. And then you need to link it to this path here, .config slash leftwm slash themes slash current. So just copy and paste that into a terminal and run that. And if you have a graphical file manager open, you'll see this directory appear, current. And it has the little arrow beside it, meaning that's a symlink. It's actually pointing somewhere else. Where is it pointing to? It's pointing to the basic polybar theme. And that's what we're looking at here. Let me go to an empty workspace. And, you know, this is what it looks like. This is not the wallpaper it comes with. This is one of my wallpapers. But the polybar that you're looking at is that poly bar. I didn't mess with the widgets or anything. I messed with the colors a little bit, but for the most part, I left all the modules and everything that were in that config as is. What I'll probably do after this video is just use my standard polybar config that I use with BSPWM and Erbsluft and a bunch of other tiling window managers. You guys have seen the polybar config that I typically use that kind of has the power line effect going on, and it has modules that I like, such as it tells me how many updates are available on my system and things like that. I don't really need to know that my keyboard layout right now is the US keyboard layout. I mean, that module's pointless. And then these with the percent sign here. I don't even know what those are offhand. 39%. What is that? Well, it's got the slash beside it, so I'm assuming that's the root mount point. It's telling me how much drive space I have probably used up, and that's probably 39% of my drive is filled. Let me get back to the workspace that had the themes. Let me show you what a theme directory in LeftWM actually looks like. So if you go into basic polybar, and again, I grabbed this from the GitHub. This is their theme that they had on the LeftWM GitHub. And you see it has a number of files in it. What are these files? Well, you have a theme.toml file. And let me open that up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to quit out of the config over here. And let's go into config /leftwm/themes/basic polybar, and let's open up the theme.toml, and it just has a few basic settings here. It's setting the border width, which is just 1 pixel wide. It's setting the margin around the windows, 8 pixels. That's my standard go-to margin size. If I want gaps around my windows, I never go above about 8 or 10 pixels. And then we have the border colors, the floating border color, the focus border color. The focus border color is the yellow that you see here. Some of the other config files in this directory are not that easy to figure out. Now, we have a shell script, change to tag. I'm assuming that has something to do with changing workspaces and how they interact with the polybar panel. You have down, which is a shell script. You also have up, which is a shell script. Now, these, let me quit out of this, and let's go to the up script here, because this is important. This is a bash script, and if you look at it, just taking a look at some of what's going on, we are running PyCom if it exists on the system. If PyCom exists, then would you launch PyCom? And I'm doing PyCom with --experimental-backend because I use a fork of PyCom called PyCom-Jonahberg, which has some fancy effects. I'm actually not using PyCom at the moment. I turned off the compositor for this video. Then I added this here, setting the background using nitrogen-restore. That's setting my wallpaper. Then at the bottom, it looks like it's calculating probably how many monitors we have, because we have monitor equals, and it's running some stuff through grep and sid. Probably wants to know how many monitors I have. I have 3 monitors, and if I have 3 monitors, it needs to know, hey, you need to launch Polybar 3 times and in these particular coordinates. And so that is what the up config file here, the up script, is doing. You can think of up as your auto start script, right? If you want something to launch as soon as you launch into LeftWM or restart LeftWM, then probably put it in the up script. One of the other config files here is polybar.config. I shouldn't have to explain what that is. That's just a polybar config file. If you've ever seen a polybar config file, you've seen them all. It's just, you know, Polybar's config file. I'm not going to go over that. One other thing, there is template.liquid here. And let me just look at that, because I'm actually not sure what is going to be in that. Some kind of script here, and it involves the tags and workspaces. I'm assuming that template.liquid and sizes.liquid have something to do with the workspaces and how things are displayed in relation to the polybar config. So I'm actually not going to play with that. I would probably need to dive into the LeftWM documentation to figure out exactly what those templates are doing, but I probably won't be playing with those unless I knew exactly what's going on with them. By the way, there is a wiki. I should have showed you guys that. There is a LeftWM wiki on GitHub too. And it tells you some of the things that are available for you in the standard config file, you know, your default LeftWM config file. So if I cd back up into this directory, I cd'd into the wrong directory. So let me vim.config/leftwmconfig.toml So this file here, if you're wondering about all the values that are possible, you know, because you got some stuff in here, most of it is key bindings. But what are you setting key bindings for? What are the functions for the bindings? Just check out this particular wiki, because there were some things missing from the default config that I wanted. For example, if I get back into the desktop here, how do I resize these windows? How do I make one window increase in width or decrease in width? That's something that all my other window managers have the ability to do. I would assume LeftWM has the ability to do that too. But in this config, nowhere in this config do I see a key binding that has anything to do with resizing the windows like that. But if you get into the wiki, it looks like increase main width, decrease main width, those are the functions that I need to add. I haven't got around to that yet. Again, I left everything as is, as the default config, but I will definitely be adding these functions to that config.toml because that's something that I use all the time. So this was just a really quick look at LeftWM out of the box for the most part. I've made very minor changes. Again, this is with Polybar. I found Polybar works perfectly with LeftWM. I did try one of the basic XMobar configs as well, and XMobar worked really well with it, but the only problem I had with the XMobar config is the windows tended to cover up the XMobar config, and I couldn't figure out why. I probably should open up an issue over at the LeftWM GitHub. So my initial impressions, just spending a couple of hours in LeftWM, is it looks like it's a really nice tiling window manager. It functions very similarly to Xmonad and Qtile, which I love. It's also SpectreWM. All four of these window managers, Xmonad, Qtile, SpectreWM, and LeftWM, function very similarly in the way they handle multi-monitors and workspaces and their dynamic layouts, you know, the master and stack layout and all that. So if you're comfortable in any of those window managers, you'll be comfortable in the other three as well. So I would be right at home with LeftWM. It's not a very old project, though. I don't think it's been under development that long, so there may be bugs, there may be pain points, but it's something I'm definitely going to keep an eye on, and I'm probably going to play around with LeftWM a little bit going forward. Now, before I go, I need to thank a few special people. I need to thank the producers of the show, Abzi, Dallas, Devin, Fran, Gabe, Lou, Corbinian, Mitchell, Akami, Arch5530, Chris, Chuck, David, the other David, Donnie, Dylan, Gregory, Lewis, Paul, Pick, DM, Scott, Wes, and Willie. They are the producers of this episode. Without these guys, I wouldn't have tried out LeftWM. Well, I probably would have because I'm a tiling window manager junkie, but still, these guys, they help out. All of these guys help out too. All of these ladies and gentlemen, they help support my work over on Patreon because the DistroTube channel has no corporate sponsors. You guys sponsor DistroTube. If you'd like to support my work, look for DT over on Patreon. All right, guys. Peace.